Alrighty, welcome back everyone. It is Laughing Games here. Today we're back with another StarCraft 2 1 vs 1 replay cast. Today we've got ourselves a Protoss vs Zerg between two great players here. The map is King Sejong Station, so a map that's not necessarily been explored too much in PvZ here, but it's likely going to be a great game here. And without further ado, spawning down on the bottom right-hand side of the map, it is the red Protoss player, not currently on a team. It is Naniwa. And his opponent, spawning up on the top left-hand side of the map, playing for True Esports, the blue Zerg, Guru. So these two players play at a very high level, even if it's not necessarily in all the tournaments or anything like that. Naniwa even sort of retired at this point and still playing at a very high level though, and these players actually have a bit of a rivalry here, so their two styles are going to clash as they know each other, and it should be a very good game here. We have the standard hatchery first on this map versus Protoss, but interestingly enough, Naniwa gone for a Nexus first into Gateway, wall off on the low ground here, so gonna try to get an early on advantage here. Now, this is a map in which Zerg can generally tries to stay on their toes, as it's quite a good map to attack Zergs on. There's rocks back here, there's an open third base. So, the Zerg generally plays defensive on this map, but now Naniwa coming out here, going for this very, very greedy opening here, getting that Nexus first, gonna want to get a very strong economy. He comes in, sees that it's just a standard hatchery first for Guru, and he knows that this build is gonna have paid off. Guru is gonna find out that this was a Nexus first. His Overlord should come in and see the Nexus timing, but at that point there's not really gonna be too much he'll be able to do about it. Naniwa getting that full wall off, a beautiful wall here by the way. Just a pylon, a gateway, and a cybernetic score, walling off everywhere but that little choke point behind the gas here. So Guru's gonna see this and he's gonna be thinking, oh, damn it. Meanwhile, Naniwa, I got his probe over here. Gonna try and deny a third base in case Guru tries to respond to greed with greed. So very well done by Naniwa here. Guru gonna harass the probe and Naniwa's gonna start running around trying to block it. Guru actually sends down the Lings now to try and get that probe. The probe's still trying to deny it as long as it can. Probe is going to go down, though, and that third base is going to go up. But now Naniwa knows the third base is on the way. He knows that Guru is responding to greed with greed. Let's get that production tab up here. We see a cybernetic score and a robo going up for Naniwa. So this could very possibly be Blink Disruptor. It could be Adepts. It could really be anything. Naniwa is a player who tends to play the older styles if you watch his game. So it's very possible that it's going to be Blink here. Getting up that robo for an observer or warp prism immortal, so it's really hard to call what Naniwa's gonna do at this point for now. Oh, look at this, he's already made up his mind here. It's actually gonna be a very, very quick dark shrine here to try and cheese out Guru, but look at this overlord coming in for Guru, gonna get a perfect scout. So Naniwa's just gonna be saying, oh god damn it, because he's seen this overlord, Guru's seen the dark shrine, and Naniwa knows that he's been completely scouted. Guru is going to know exactly how to respond to this build for Naniwa. Now, Naniwa set himself up with a Twilight Council, which you need for a Dark Shrine. It's not like he was super committed. So he's going to let this Dark Shrine finish from the looks of it. And he's going to try to get harassment done with the DTs. But he knows that he's not going to straight out win the game with these DTs. So he will be in a sort of better position than a Dark Templar player who is just hard countered with things like spores already. So we see Guru, that third base is now up. Players are equal on workers, but the Zerg is going to start to pull ahead on drones. Guru can just pump them out. Getting out a Roach Warren, getting up an Evolution Chamber Lair, everything sort of just starting to roll out here for the Zerg player. Meanwhile, Naniwa is getting up that Mothership Core 4 defense here. Possibly going to be going for a third base soon. Yes, he is. That Ling might have seen that probe go out, but Naniwa is going to be able to get up to space without it being denied by the looks of it. There's actually so few units on the map right now that neither player really needs to be worrying. about aggression. I mean, Guru's aware of these Dark Templar here. And Nanny was actually just warped in four. Looks like he's going to try and target in the Spore Crawler. Oh my, look at this. Guru knew this attack was coming, but the Spore Crawler goes down immediately. There is a Lair done, so an Overseer is morphing, but it seems that Nanny might get this hatchery before that happens, and this is unacceptable for Guru. He knew there was Dark Templar. And look at this, Nanny was just going to lift off Guru, now supply block, now his economy is going to be behind, incredibly behind, as Nanny was getting up a third base of his own. He's got a Mothership Core there to defend it, and now he's actually morphed these DPs into Archons here. He's going to be able to lift them up into the Prism here and try to get some harassment done. There are Roaches for Guru, but these Archons are just so tough, they can try to get harassment done regardless. Look at this, three Roaches to defend from these, that's not enough here. If the Archon starts to get hurt, Nanniwa just picks him up and goes away. He is going to get away with that Prism, though. Its shields are gone. But look at this. All these drones here exposed. Nanniwa's going to come in and start dropping and harassing. How often do you see Archon harassment? Just popping those drones like they're no sweat. Just murdering these Roaches very quickly. Now, the Warp Prism is going to have to get out there. These Queens with their long range going to shoot away. Getting a bit low there. But anyway, he's got a follow-up now. He's getting more gateways, he's getting a forge, he's getting resonating glyphs, so he is going to go into these adepts, and he's even got an immortal, and he's going to be producing more here. Meanwhile, Guru, gotten up a spire at this point. While he did lose his third base and he's going to be on a low economy, he's going to respond to it with Mutalisk, and Nanniwa hasn't scouted this. Guru moving across the map with Lings, by the way, to try and get some counter damage done, but this third base is established right now, and there's really no killing off pylons with Lings. Well, with a small amount of Lings. Look at this, Nanniwa in the middle of the map dropping these Archons, picking off a good amount of Lings there from the look of it. Now, the main point here, though, is the Mutas for Guru. He's already at 5. He's going to be getting up. He's going to be at about 10 instantly. Nanniwa is now just starting Blink, but it's only powered by one pylon. So these Mutas, they can kill off probes. They can force warpins. They can unpower buildings if they choose to. Guru, while the start of the game was a bit bumpy, he's now in an amazing position with these Mutas. He's going to be able to start trying to get some harassment done. But look at this. He's actually coming back with these Mutalisk. And this could be a wrong call here from Guru. It might have been better if he just went for the base trade. Yes, he managed to pick off the Warp Prism, and that is big. I think he bled off one or two Mutas there. But Nanniwa has a scary army. Nanniwa can likely push in regardless. If anything, he'll be lacking AA. But Guru had a chance to get some very good damage done there, but I guess him pulling back his Mutalisk changed Nanniwa's mind. Nanniwa now pulling back here. One Muta getting dangerously close. Nanniwa now has had a chance to morph in a few Stalkers. His Blink is getting Chrono boosted out, as he knows that's the only way he's going to respond to these Mutas up until these two Stargates finish up for Nanniwa. I'd like to see a cannon or two for Nanniwa at this third base to defend it, but Mothership Core has so smartly moved over. Photon Overcharge is shooing away these Mutalisks, buying time until that Blink is done. We now see Guru still on a terrible income. He's only just transferring and getting up this third base mining. So Nanniwa's had an incredible economic advantage this whole game. He's now going to have an upgrade advantage here. Both players are 1-1 right now, but plus 2 is on the way for Nanniwa. He's now getting out Phoenix, and this advantage that Guru has is sort of quickly disappearing with these Mutalisks. Like, the tech advantage not going to be there once, say, 4 Phoenix are out. Nanniwa getting up a 4th base. This game is going to be going into a macro game from the looks of it. A proper macro game here. The two Archons are really the only thing in Nanniwa's main ground army to shoo away these Mutalisks. Mutalisk coming into the third base here, going to get some harassment done, and this is why I would have loved to see some cannons for Nanniwa to defend this here. A few probes go down, but Nanniwa's still ahead on workers right now because of that early third base kill. Few Phoenix are out, going to be able to start picking away at these Mutalisks. One goes down from the Stalkers. The Phoenix is going to chase down. Phoenix, one of them is getting low though. Nanniwa needs to have very good control as he doesn't have the upgrade which gives the Phoenix more range. Antium Pulse Crystals, I believe it is. We now see Phoenix count, though, building up for Nanniwa, and this is basically forcing Guru to go into Hydras. His likely follow-up to these Hydras is going to be Lurkers here, and there is a Lurker down on the way. So Zergs really like to play either Lings and Ravagers. mutas and lings or lurkers and hydras. And Guru's gone from one tech and now he's going into another here. Great Phoenix control by Nanua. Manages to kill off all those mutas, and now he's got control with the skies. He's got that map control. He's down in overall supply right now. But if we look at the units, there's a good amount of roaches for Guru, and that's not necessarily a good amount right now. As the supplies increase and the players get more maxed, you don't necessarily want a lot of roaches versus a large immortal count. Nanua currently on 2 and needs to identify that this is sort of roach lurker here coming out of Guru. So then he can continue to make more mortals. He's getting up another robo, so I think he's identified this here. These Phoenix have sort of gotten off the scout here. Now there's actually not much anti-air in Guru's army right now. He morphed so many Hydras. He's only got 2 Hydras in this entire army, so the Phoenix could start picking off units here. We now see Guru moving to the 4th base and Nanua trying to attack as much as he can here. Plus 3 attack could be cancelled. Players are on even upgrades at this point in the game. Nanua still is going to have a lot of tech, and his army is going to be a lot more scary in a minute here. He's getting up an Oracle for Revelation here on Lurkers. He's getting up a Storm, which is going to be very important and very effective versus this composition if used correctly. Nanua threw up a bunch of Panic Pylons here to chew away these Lurkers, but he's not even going to have to. The Lurkers are now, well, the army for Guru is now moving towards the front, but look at this, some Phoenix of Nanua. He has the air control. He's managed to pick up a Lurker or two here. I believe he killed one and almost killed another. Now Ling's trying to get a counterattack, but Nanua's definitely got cannons at this 4th base now. And look at this, Guru's just going back and forth. He's not exactly sure what to do. But as this goes on, the position isn't really getting better for Guru. He's getting +1 air attack in case he needs to go to Corruptors or possibly Broodlords in the future. But for now, he's just pumping out this ground army, which is going to be less and less effective as time goes on. Nanua building up Immortals, he's going to have Storm here. As a matter of fact, Nanua making Dark Templar, and Guru doesn't have an Observer with these roaches. Nanua needs to throw up a butt ton of Photon Overcharges here, but he does lose that +3 attack, and that was actually massive for Guru right there. Nanua's +3 attack was in a vulnerable position, and he got punished for it. Now throwing up a single another Forge, so Guru is actually going to be in a bit of an upgrade advantage here. He'll have the 2-1 versus Nanua's +2. Not the most important in Protoss versus Zerg, but it's an advantage. And it's going to put Nanua in a worse position here. Nanua actually throwing up a second Forge here, so he is going to try and get it 2 upgrades of his own by the looks of things. Guru now teching here. He's getting up an Infestation Pit, so this possibly means it obviously means he's going to go for a Hive and later tech at some point. But the question is, what tech is he going to go for? A greater spire? Quite possibly he already has the spire, he just needs to get a hive. Maybe he'll actually just stick to infestors. +3 once again on the way for Nanua. Now we actually have a Depths fighting roaches, possibly like the slowest fight ever we can see. Mothership core with a bit of energy. There's that mothership core. Photon overcharge is going to try and help push that army back, but Nanua does lose most of those adepts here as they can't exactly trade efficiently versus roach hydra. Guru's actually spread his creep out very far, but look at this, Nanua's going for a counterattack on the left here. Guru trying to outposition Nanua with these lurkers, though. Phoenix come and lift up almost all of the lurkers for Guru here. The lurkers are let down as the Hydras shoo away the Phoenix, so could have been a very terrible position for Guru there, but he managed to sort of salvage it. Force fields are trapping off part of Guru's army. He went for sort of a two-pronged attack, but the force fields are preventing that now. Nanua's army is looking a little small though compared to that of Guru's right now. It's sort of split up, but now it's sort of consolidating in the center, starting to pick off Guru's army here. Nanua down on supply right now. He does still have these 4 immortals and Archon, very weak. Stalker starting to get picked off. And there is an Observer for Nanua, so these Immortals do need to pick off these Lurkers. Stalkers blink forward, trying to pick off 2 of the Lurkers, gets one of them. The Lurker does manage to burrow, though. Ling's surrounding an Immortal for Nanua, but it seems that Nanua just has so much more mass right now in army, and good game is called. Well, there was actually no GG there, I don't think, but very well played by Nanua, managing to take that game. It looked a little rocky. It wasn't sort of a straightforward engagement. Things were sort of going on all over, but Nanua sort of had the better tech, the better army, and it eventually won out. though that was a very nice macro game between these two players. Guru still had lots of money in the bank. Naniwa had lots of money in the bank, but Guru wouldn't have been able to consolidate, I guess, not to push back the army in Naniwa. He also lost that fifth base. So, very well played by Naniwa. And if you guys have enjoyed this cast, feel free to let me know. If you have feedback, feel free to let me know. I'm always trying to improve my casting. If you have any players to cast, maybe I'll try to cast a game of a certain player you want to see. But anyway, Naniwa actually puts out replays for free, so we might actually cast a couple more of his games. Regardless, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.